Hello. In this video, we will discuss dietary recommendations for exercise. There are two key concepts I want you to keep in mind throughout this video, and the first is that diet does not directly influence the fuel used for energy. So, for example, if we eat more fat, that does not mean that we are going to burn more fat. And then, likewise, diet does not directly influence body composition. So, if we eat more protein, that does not mean that we are going to build more muscle. Hopefully, we are really driving home the message that you are not what you eat. So now the question is, how do you fuel for exercise? To answer this question, we're going to walk through the recommendations for each one of these categories, starting with fluids. So in your notes, you can find specific recommendations for before, during, and after exercise, but this is going to vary based on the type of exercise and the conditions. In hotter weather, it is especially important to prevent dehydration of more than 2% of your body weight and to replenish with sports beverages containing electrolytes. For anything less than an hour, you can drink to thirst with the goal of starting hydrated and not overhydrated and then replenishing afterwards. So we'll say drink to thirst or prevent greater than a 2% loss. For vitamins and minerals, research has consistently shown that vitamin and mineral supplementation does not improve performance. So for these two, we're going to say follow the RDAs. However, iron is one nutrient that is frequently marginal in female diets, and athletes may need as much as 30 to 70% more iron than the general population. So athletes should monitor iron. And their blood status. For fats, high-fat diets are not recommended for athletes, but also low-fat diets are not beneficial. Dietary recommendations for fat intakes for athletes are the same as for the general population. So we're going to say follow the AMDR, which is going to be 20 to 35% of your total kcals. Next, we have carbohydrates, and the need for carbohydrates is going to be related to maintaining your glycogen stores so that there's fuel available and maintaining blood glucose during the activity. So if you watch part two of this video, we'll go into the specifics for carbohydrate need and timing. So next we're going to look at protein, and this need is going to be related to sufficient substrate to build lean body mass, and then also providing enough amino acids to meet glucose production needs during endurance events, and so that'll be through gluconeogenesis when there's not enough glucose and you have to also rely on those proteins, and that's only when we deplete our glycogen stores. So overall, dietary intake for protein can vary based on gender, age, intensity, duration, the type of activity, and the carbohydrate availability. And the greatest need is going to be for a new bodybuilder because they're trying to build up a lot of new muscle versus somebody maintaining that muscle or somebody who doesn't do strength training a lot. So in summary, the most important dietary changes for exercise are going to be your proteins and carbohydrates to keep up with energy demands. So over here, we're going to say the most important factors are for energy and then also fluids. And that's going to be for exercise greater than an hour. Okay, so in part two of this video, like I said, we're going to look at specific recommendations for carbohydrates and proteins, but that's all that I have for now. Thank you and have a great day.